This video is on the topic of how the enzyme amylase can be used to investigate how enzymes are affected by temperature and pH. It is possible to carry out practical investigations into how temperature and pH affect enzyme action. In these experiments, we use the enzyme amylase, which breaks down the substrate starch into a type of sugar called maltose. We use an indicator called iodine to test for the presence of starch. When the amylase has not yet broken down all the starch, it will cause the starch to turn the iodine blue-black. However, once all the starch has been broken down into maltose, the iodine will no longer change colour and will stay orange. We can use this mechanism to investigate the rate of enzyme action at different temperatures and pH levels. First, we start by heating a solution containing starch to a set temperature, such as 30 degrees Celsius. This can be done using a Bunsen burner or a water bath. Whilst waiting for the solution to reach the correct temperature, the spotting towel can be prepared by placing a couple of drops of iodine into each of the wells. Once it has reached the correct temperature, the enzyme amylase is added. At this point, the amylase will start digesting the starch. The timer is started. Once a minute has passed, a sample of the solution is transferred into the first well of the tile. At this temperature, the starch should not be fully digested yet, and so the iodine turns blue-black. This process is repeated a minute later, with the iodine reacting to the continued presence of starch by turning blue-black. We can now take a look and see how the spotting tile appears over the course of the next few minutes. The iodine will continue to turn blue-black as the starch continues to be broken down by the amylase. Eventually, when the quantity of starch goes down, there may be slightly less colour change by the iodine. Once all the starch has been broken down, the iodine will remain orange. Here you can see that it took 5 minutes at 30 degrees Celsius. The next step is to repeat this entire process at different temperatures. At 20 degrees, the amylase is very slow to break down the starch because of the low kinetic energy in the solution and few collisions between the active site and substrates. It takes 9 minutes for the iodine to remain orange. At 40 degrees, the kinetic energy is higher, and it only takes 3 minutes for all the starch to be broken down. At 60 degrees, the iodine turns blue-black for the whole experiment. This is because the amylase is denatured, and so none of the starch is broken down to maltose. We can carry out the following investigation to see how pH affects enzyme action of amylase. First, we start by preparing a spotting tile with a couple of drops of iodine in each well. The next step in the investigation is to measure out all the solutions we need. Here we have one test tube with 1 cm³ of pH 7 buffer solution and 2 cm³ of amylase solution. There is also a second tube with 2 cm³ of starch solution. When the experiment is ready to start, the contents of the two tubes are mixed together and a timer is immediately started. At this point, the amylase enzyme will start breaking down the starch into maltose. After 10 seconds, use a pipette to transfer a couple of drops of the starch and amylase solution into the first well of the spotting tile. At this point, the colour of the iodine should change to blue-black because the starch has not yet been fully broken down. 10 seconds later, repeat this process and the iodine should turn blue-black again. Continue repeating every 10 seconds until the iodine no longer changes colour. This will indicate when all of the starch has been broken down into maltose. At pH 7, this is 60 seconds. Once this has been recorded, the experiment can be repeated using different pH buffer solutions. At pH 5 and 9, the rate is slower because this is not the optimal pH for this enzyme. At pH 14, the enzyme is denatured, and so the starch is never fully broken down. If the experiment was repeated at a much lower pH, such as pH 2, the amylase would also have denatured. Remember that this experiment was just for amylase. If this experiment was repeated with a different enzyme, the results may have been varied due to the different enzymes having different optimum pH values. In summary, the enzyme amylase can be investigated. Amylase breaks down starch into maltose background iodine turns blue-black in the presence of starch. So this can be tracked during an experiment to see how long it takes amylase to break down starch in different conditions. In different temperature conditions, starch breaks down the amylase slowly at low temperatures, and this speed increases with increasing temperature. At high temperatures, the amylase denatures and no longer breaks down the starch. How amylase is affected by pH can also be investigated, with pH values above and below the optimum, causing the speed of the starch breakdown to be lower, and in some cases the starch is not broken down at all because the amylase is denatured. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.